Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna teach you how people over 40 can reoptimize the thyroid gland. Now, if you don't know this already, the thyroid is often considered the master gland of the fat-burning metabolism because it helps control your basal metabolic rate. It controls the speed of your metabolism. It also regulates your body weight. It helps with digestion, muscle gains, and muscle control. It helps with brain health, bone density, and it helps regulate other hormones. You can see a list of them over here. Now, over at my website, I'm gonna go over these other hormones with you. So if you click the link around this video and go over to my website, you'll see a bunch of published research studies at the bottom, backing up everything that I talk about in this video so you know it's based on real science. But don't click or tap that link yet. Let's talk about the symptoms of a low-functioning thyroid. First one is abdominal obesity, excessive storage in the belly region, weight loss plateaus, brain fog, dry skin, hair loss, depression, and fatigue, just to name a few. Now, fortunately, there's a specific reason this stuff happens, and there's a specific solution that you can use that I'm going to share with you right now. So the first problem is low iodine. Now, this is especially important if you're trying the keto or the paleo diet. Now, both of these diets can be very effective. I'm not demonizing them, but they're not designed for the current hormonal condition of people over 40 years old. But you can still use them to get amazing results. You just have to use the advice that I give you in this video. So the first thing is understanding that iodine is necessary for thyroid hormones to be produced. And the American diet has plummeted in iodine up to 50% from 1971 to the year 2000. So all you have to do is add in some sea veggies, some kelp, some seaweed. You could also add in other seafoods like cod and scallops. Raw dairy is another good one. Just make sure that it's raw. Pasteurized processed dairy is not nearly as healthy for you. In fact, most lactose intolerant people can tolerate raw dairy. You just have to experiment and see how it works. The second thing is selenium over here. So iodine and selenium. Selenium is also necessary for the body to produce thyroid hormones. And an easy way to get your daily dose of selenium is just have 3 or 4 Brazil nuts. You don't need any more than that because you can actually get an overdose of selenium if you eat any more than that. So that's the best source. The second one is raw sunflower seeds and then mushrooms. All these foods are rich in selenium, and this will help you increase thyroid hormones. The second problem is lack of protein and glucose. Now, the lack of protein is especially a problem with the popular plant-based vegan and vegetarian diets. So although it can be very healthy in certain ways, the protein quality is so low that research shows the liver won't respond to the thyroid. So if you're vegan or vegetarian, it means you're not gonna eat the foods that are rich in protein like animal meats and eggs and raw dairy. So my recommendation is if you are vegan, if you are a vegetarian, to buy a high quality, complete protein powder, plant protein powder, that you can use to incorporate this so you can increase the protein quality of your diet to avoid a lot of these negative side effects. Now, glucose is a building block of TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. Now, one thing that the keto diet lacks is glucose. There's no glucose in it, it's only 5% carbs. Paleo is also very low on carbs and can lack glucose, but it's especially prevalent with the keto diet. Now, the solution to this is very simple. At a specific time each week, if you eat a strategic high-carb cheat meal that has glucose in it, now you're re-spiking your thyroid. And what happens is your body's ability to convert T4 to T3 increases. You just have to make sure you time this the right way. And I teach you more about that over at my website. And the last thing is age-related hormonal decline. After age 35, hormone levels inside the body start declining rapidly, especially growth hormone. This is a condition known as somatopause. Now, I have created something called the Over 40 Hormone Reset Solution that you'll learn about over at my website. It's specifically designed to help people over 40 reoptimize declining hormones. Now, research from the Journal of Obesity shows that people who focus solely on hormones lose 65% more weight than those focusing on starving themselves and keeping their body in a calorie deficit. So hormones are the key. It's not about calories in, calories out as much as it is about hormones. So growth hormone can be increased up to 1,200% when you follow my meal timing tricks over at my website. Leptin levels will be reset simply by adding in these high-carb cheat meals. So it'll not only reset thyroid, it'll help you with leptin. Leptin is considered the number one fat-burning hormone. Cortisol, your stress hormone, can be balanced out. Melatonin will be induced at night, so you can go into a deep sleep. Ghrelin, your hunger hormone. I'll show you how to decrease and eliminate your hunger and cravings, and I'll also teach you exactly how to combine your foods so that you keep insulin levels stable. This is critically important. If you don't combine your foods the right way, anytime you eat food, you raise insulin. So it's not just carbs that spike insulin. Anytime you eat food. So by combining your foods the right way, you can keep insulin stable, and it keeps the body in an environment where it can easily access fat as a fuel source. So if you want to learn more about my Over 40 Hormone Reset Solution, click the link around this video. Thanks for taking time out of your busy day to check this out, and God bless.